In this video, I am going to explain anatomy of trapezius. This is trapezius. This is on backside of body. It's very broad and big muscle. I'm gonna explain its origin, insertion, and function. There are three fibers in trapezius. This part, and this part. Upper part is upper fiber, of course. This part is middle fiber. This part is lower fiber. Okay, let's look at origin first. Origin of trapezius is very, very broad. I will explain superior to inferior. Superior part, okay, this is occiput. Okay, it attaches on head, okay? And it's on nuchal ligament. Nuchal ligament is thick connective tissue on cervical spine. So you can say basically it's from cervical spine, okay? And spinal process of T1 through T12. Spinal process of T1 through T12. To be simple, it's from occiput, cervical spine, all the way down to T12. See that? It's very, very broad origin. This is origin. Let's check at its insertion. Insertion is basically on shoulder girdle, this area. It inserts to lateral part of clavicle. Lateral part of clavicle. It's on anterior part, right? How about this part? This is acromion. Acromion. And rest of the part is spine of scapula. Spine of scapula. Origin is basically the axial skeleton, okay? Insertion is around shoulder girdle. That's it. Very simple, right? Now, let's look at its function. As I said, there are three fibers in trapezius. Upper fiber, middle fiber, and lower fiber. General function of trapezius is scapular adduction. Adduction, okay? Scapular adduction is this movement. You bring scapula towards thoracic spine. This is general function. That means each fiber can do adduction, okay? All three fibers can do adduction. But if you look each fiber, it can do specific movements. Let's check out the superior fiber. This is superior fiber. When this contracts, that can bring scapula to elevation. Okay, elevation is like you shrink shoulder. That is elevation. And the direction of fiber is kind of diagonal, right? Then when muscle pulls scapula this way, this fiber can do rotational movement for scapula. This is upward rotation. Upward rotation. This rotational movement of scapula is crucial for shoulder movement. Upward rotation, okay? Thus, when this movement is inhibited, maybe upper fiber is tight, that can affect movement of shoulder joint. Very important movement. Upper fiber can do elevation and upward rotation. Plus, how about middle fiber? Specific movement is adduction. Okay, because the fiber of this muscle is pretty much horizon, right? So when this muscle contracts, that can bring scapula this way. Not much rotational movement. Simply scapular adduction. Let's go to inferior fiber. Okay, this is inferior fiber. This fiber can do two movements. That is depression. Depression of scapula and upward rotation. That's kind of weird, isn't it? Because if you see orientation of this fiber, it doesn't look like this fiber can do upward rotation. I will explain why. So, the attachment of lower fiber is about this area. What happens when lower fiber contracts this way? That kind of brings force to scapula this way. It's kind of a scratching movement, right? It's like this, you know, kind of a scratchy movement. This vector can bring scapula towards upward rotation. Kind of scratch movement. This scratch makes upward rotation. You know, scratching means just analogy. I am giving you easy visualization. Attachment of lower fiber is here, where muscle contracts this way. This can bring to upward rotation. Thus, both upper fiber and lower fiber can do upward rotation. As I said, upward rotation is important for shoulder movement, not only for scapular movement. So when trapezius is inhibited, that can affect movement of shoulder joint. Thus, trapezius is important for shoulder movement, even though it doesn't attach to humerus. Very important. Plus, if you think about origin of trapezius, it's from axial skeleton, right? So it can move spines. Let me explain that. Okay, I would like to focus on upper part. When both sides of trapezius contract, that can bring to neck extension. Okay, neck extension. But how about when one side contracts? What's going to happen to axial skeleton? That brings to side bend. Okay, side bend. This is one side of contraction. Neck extension is by bilateral contraction. Bilateral means two sides. Okay, and one more function from one side contraction. That is rotation. Okay, rotation. But which direction? When right side of fiber contracts, that brings to left rotation, okay? Left rotation. Right side brings to left side rotation. This kind of opposite direction means contralateral. Thus, contralateral rotation. Contralateral rotation. Again, when right side contracts, that brings to left rotation. When left side contracts, that brings to right rotation. This means contralateral rotation. Again, when both side contracts, that brings to neck extension. When one side contracts, it brings to side bend and contralateral rotation. Trapezius is important for both axial skeletal movement and scapular movement. In this video, I explained basic anatomy and function of trapezius. If you liked today's video, please hit the like button. comment, and subscribe. See you next video.